Bears is one of the longest-running songwriting teams in theater history. Collaborators and friends for more than 36 years, they continue to create vital and vibrant entertainment that audiences just can't seem to get enough of. And all that jazz, I'm gonna... In 1962, composer John Kander and lyricist Fred Ebb were introduced by their publisher, and the result was Barbra Streisand's hit song, My Coloring Book. It earned them their first Grammy nomination and was the beginning of a collaboration that would produce some of the most memorable songs in show business. Producer Harold Prince took notice and in 1965 hired the young team to score Flora the Red Menace for legendary director George Abbott. The show launched the career of 18-year-old Liza Minnelli, who went on to win a Tony Award for her starring role. Flora had a brief run, but Variety conjectured, the songs indicate that Broadway may have an able new tunester team. A week before Flora premiered, Prince invited Kander and Ebb to write the score for a musical adaptation of the play, I Am a Camera. They wrote nearly four dozen songs before coming up with just the right mix. The result, Cabaret, revolutionized American musical theater. It opened in 1966, ran for more than 1,100 performances, and received 8 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. Cabaret earned Kander and Ebb a Grammy, the Drama Desk Award, the New York Drama Critics Circle Award, and their first Tony for Best Composer and Lyricist. The end of the 1960s was a busy time for Kander and Ebb. In 1968, they had 2 shows on Broadway, The Happy Time and Zorba, each earning them Tony and Grammy nominations. Zorba later enjoyed a highly successful revival, starring Anthony Quinn. They began the next decade with 70 Girls 70, and soon turned their talents to another medium. In 1972, they joined forces with Bob Fosse to create the brilliant and deliciously tawdry film version of Cabaret. It was a box office smash and won 8 Academy Awards. They were soon tapped to compose the film scores for Funny Lady, which earned them an Oscar nomination, and New York, New York, whose theme song became one of their biggest hits and the official anthem of the city of New York.
Start spreading the news.
In 1975, Kander and Ebb again teamed with Bob Fosse, this time to create both the book and the score for the sensational hit Chicago, starring Gwen Verdon, Chita Rivera, and Jerry Orbach. With a remarkable run of 898 performances, Chicago earned Kander and Ebb another Tony nomination. The New York Post's Martin Gottfried proclaimed, "The music, hands down, is John Kander's best score yet. And as for Ebb's lyrics, they're masterful." How can they see with sequence? Kander and Ebb closed out an extraordinary decade with The Act, Liza Minnelli's spectacular tour de force, which won her another Tony Award. The 1980s began on a high note when the incomparable songwriters took home their second Tony for Woman of the Year, starring Lauren Bacall. And in 1984, they teamed with playwright Terrence McNally to create The Rink, starring Chita Rivera and Liza Minnelli, and earning Kander and Ebb another Tony nomination. The 1990s have been some of the busiest years yet for Kander and Ebb. A triumphant review of their work, And the World Goes Round, premiered in 1991. 2 years later, they joined with Harold Prince and Terrence McNally to create Kiss of the Spider Woman, which garnered 7 Tonys, including Best Musical, and for which Kander and Ebb received the Drama Desk Award, the New York Drama Critics Circle Award, and their 3rd Tony. In the words of Harold Prince, "What John and Fred have always done is as relevant now as it was then, and will always be." So it's fitting that some of today's hottest musicals are revivals of their hit shows. But that's not enough to satisfy the creative energies of John Kander and Fred Ebb. They continue to create new musicals, including 1997's Steel Pier, and most recently, Over and Over, which premiered in Washington. "When we get together to work," says John Kander, "we create a third person called Kander and Ebb, and that is who writes the songs." What has lasted says Fred Ebb, is the love and the passion, the particular thrill you get when you hear a baton knock against a music stand and you know it's going to begin. Simply said, I just love it. Of the volumes written and spoken about the legendary songwriting team, playwright Terrence McNally has said it best. John Kander and Fred Ebb are at this moment in our story the very best we have. Time and time again, they have taken the pulse of our nation and given it expression. These are words and music the next generations will know and love as well. Nothing can top that. Nothing.